You are here at this job summit because you know how important jobs are to the country and to every person and every family that loses one.
3,100 people left in that month alone, and for the year to June, 29,900 people. Yes. I mean, you sat in a stadium last election campaign, didn't you?
Yes.
To illustrate a sports stadium full of people were leaving to Australia, and you failed to stem that tide. But you promised also to, and I quote you again, maintain a low level of inflation at the start of the year. You failed. 5.3%, highest in 21 years.
Yeah,
it's real.
Yeah, but it's real.
Not some technical discussion, is it? If you're sitting at home and your food bill's gone up because of GST, then you feel that.
Yes.
Books are in the red. Debt is forecast to rise dramatically over the next few years. We have to get on top of that debt. If we don't, our children and our grandchildren will pay with reduced living standards.
One of the key indicators of wages, and one of the key ones that your government set, was catching up to Australian incomes. Are you making any progress in that regard?
You know, I think we are.
Honourable Paula Bennett.
Mr Speaker, these are time-ticking bombs that are about to go off. These young people deserve our attention. They deserve us putting everything behind them.
Books are in the red. Debt is forecast to rise dramatically over the next few years. We have to get on top of that debt. If we don't, our children and our grandchildren will pay with reduced living standards.
Extreme poverty exists in this country, but those helping the lowest income earners say it does. No one can provide precise figures, but children are going without food and dying of third world diseases, which doctors say aren't seen in any other developed country.